served. It's my great delight to be here. My name is Lydia Manene. I serve as Vice President for Biblica in Africa, and Dr. Ojiambo is our chairman. I'm going to read a few remarks from Dr. Ojiambo. Remarks by Dr. Fred N. Ojiambo, Senior Counsel, on the occasion of the launch of the book, Courage is a Calling, Saving Mombasa Street Children, written by Lucy Washo Yinda, occasion happening at Bahari Beach Hotel. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my pride and joy to be associated with the launch of this thrilling publication, Courage is a Calling. The book is an account of the beginnings and growth of what we now know as the Wema Center. More significantly, however, it is a chronicle of the fearless odyssey by an individual in fervent pursuit of a dream, even ourselves to it. This is the story of Wema, but it is also the challenge on all of us. We will never solve the riddle of poverty by merely extending a helping hand. Dr. Fred N. Ojiambo, MBS, SC at Bahari Beach Hotel. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much.
Yes,
let's see it.
So you start on page 1 and then you get to page 127. You will read what I have said. Let me just say that, you know, Lucy, you're a very special person. Because there are not many people in this country or in this world, actually, who do what you're doing from the bottom of their heart. A lot of people do things, and believe you me, I know, because I know a lot of politicians and other people. So they do it for personal gain. It's a time for us also to have some introspection and ask ourselves, how many of us can actually do something like that for nothing? And even put in the effort to look for people to support your cause, which is not a common cause. When we have drug abuse, child abuse, we heard about rape, we heard about drug abuse, child alcohol abuse. Please, you know, society, we have a society that needs, yeah? And there's only so much that special people like Lucy can do. You see, even as individuals, those of us who support and sponsor, there's only so much we can do. Why don't we lessen the problem instead of making it bigger? Yeah. So that's my message for today, that we look inside ourselves. Let's leave the government to do what they can, but usually their priority is where there will be political, and should I say, when I grow up, I hope I can be like you.
We were taught well at Wema Center. We were guided. We were actually given everything that a child needed. In school, we didn't look different because of you, Mama Wema. Thank you very much. I know, Sharon, you said I'm a professional, yes. And when you were singing to the guest, the sponsors, them, I could not imagine today I'd stand with a mic and speak to the guest sitting, you know, in front of me. It's actually a dream come true. So what I would like to say, Mama Wema, thank you very much for the sacrifice. We actually appreciate you. We are praying for you. Thank you, Dalinda, for all that you have done in our lives. And thank you for the sponsors. Whatever little you give actually produces someone like me. Thank you. And God bless you.
What goes on in Mama Lucy's mind? You know, when you've seen the kids from that point up to right now, a serious person at Safaricom.
I needed as I hit the road all the way to the ferry area to beg. This was my routine for several weeks, and it seemed unending. Even though I was living in the streets and I befriended other kids, I was always independent. I never moved around with a group or joined any gang. I always kept to myself. This was my life until Wema rescued me. And just before I go, when I was rescued at Wema, you know, I met a social worker. Please make sure you read my story, yeah? Yeah, I was jumping so that at least you could get a rough idea. I was rescued by a social worker who met me at the ferry. And I accompanied him to Wema Center. And while we were there, you know, of course, I saw these beautiful faces of beautiful children, wonderful, you know, all jumping around. And I was like, okay, kumbe kuna mbinguni. Yeah, so there's a heaven around here. And I was like, you know, this is what I want. So the social worker told me, you be coming in the morning and then in the evening you go back to the streets. And that was my routine. Until one day, you know, I said what? I am not going. And I refused to leave. Look at me now. Thank you.
Well done, Mwas.
She was not performing. So I had to be on a case all the time. Thank you everyone for making time, for being here today. You really look nice, all of you. I'm going to read part of my story. The rest you read for yourself. My journey starts on a bright Sunday morning in our village in Uyoma, Siaya County, in Nyanza, on the shores of Lake Victoria. The area used to be a thriving cotton-growing region. It had black cotton soil that cracks under the high temperatures, making it good for growing cotton. However, there are no cotton fields anymore. When the giant Kisumu cotton mills Kikomi collapsed, as did the textile industry countrywide, it went down with the livelihoods of many. the burial rites over, my mother's coffin was lowered into the grave. The visitors and mourners,
Coachella, thank you for sharing. I want to invite
a spoiler alert, because unlike many of the speeches you've had today, I'm going to try and give you a glimpse of some of the things that are not in the book, but some of the things that are so fundamental to the success that WEMA has become. When you look at the title of the book, Courage is a Calling, it's difficult to
our lady of the day to come and speak to us what is in her heart, share with us a huge round of applause. Shall we
start? Amazing, and like, it's really nice to see you. I would like to start by saying thank you to my publisher, James, standing over there, James Chunguli. My editor, Tim Toroni, I think he has left. He had some business to attend to. And the WEMA committee, I had a small WEMA committee that was like a think tank that helped me to put this book together. I'd like to maybe you can just stand up, those who are in that little group. Thank you, because you actually made on and to help me celebrate the occasion of launching this book, Courage is a Calling. It's a book that took a lot of time, energy, labor of love. So I'm really excited to finally be able to share it with you. Thank you, everyone. Thank you so much. Just a little bit about the journey of writing a book. The book is about my over 25 years effort, crusade, some people call it, for liberation of street children. I've done this for a very long time. I think I was young when I started. Dr. Minor, you remember? He was also a young man when he was helping me through some of the challenges. And it's been quite an experience. Writing a book is not an easy thing, and so there will be another book. I'm not letting this experience go to waste. So, thank you. It's about my struggles, my personal struggles in that journey. When I started, I thought it was going to be a 10-year, 5-year, very short time. But 30 years later, here I am standing doing the same thing. The struggles were some of them very animated. You would be surprised finding me running in the streets with a woman chasing me with a knife, or being made by the police to lie down on the grass on my stomach with my hands up because they thought I was a drug peddler or something as vicious or evil as that. And I was learning how to navigate the streets, how to understand the street people. Those of you who know me, I think you all do actually, you know that I was born in a fairly safe place. My parents were civil servants, and we had safety. So the streets were scary, really scary. It took courage. It took courage to get in there and learn how to, you know, walk the streets. But I did. I did, and I have no regrets. Other struggles included fighting with government. Fighting with government, not easy at all. There's no winning, but we are still here. So to a certain extent, we've won, actually. I would struggle just getting birth certificates and death and ID cards for the children. I still do, if that is still a problem. Apart from that, we were being moved around. We would rent places in town, and somebody would come and say, "You're not supposed to be here," and we would move on. So there were struggles. Along the way, though, God sent his angels to help me. And I got surprising support. One of them is sitting over there. She was a children officer then. And all of you who have stood up today who work day and night to raise funds for WEMA. And there are so many, so many angels. I can see Liz, Pastor T, I still call him Pastor, although I think he's a big bishop nowadays. He would come and baptize the children and teach them the basics of Christianity. And at that time, people didn't really want to associate with this crazy crusader. So along the way, we found help. And that's why we are still here. Other struggles. Those struggles have not ended, but I think the stories you've had today are testimony that it's okay, it's okay. I believe in the faithfulness of God. He did his wonders. I'm not a preacher, Pastor Reverend, forgive me to even try, but let me tell you, I have seen miracles upon miracles upon miracles. I am going to write another book just about those. Because there were days when we would sit and wonder where the next food is coming from. And with these children, okay, those ones were not there, but there were others like Susan, Natasha, and others, we would hold hands and pray. And the next thing is a call. I remember one very dramatic situation where I got a call from some shipping company that I had never heard of. And they said, "We have a vessel that is carrying a lot of food and they've decided they want to bring it to your institution." I said, "Okay. And where are you?" So I tried to explain where we were. And they said, "Can you send us a fax with your directions?" By the way, they used to be faxes, so they used to. And yes, I sketched the map and sent a fax, and a truck came loaded with food that lasted us 6 good months. And by the way, it was raining, so it got stuck in our compound because of the weight. And we had to get it removed through other means. And that's how God has been faithful. When we moved to Bamburi, people were saying tunawaletea machokora. And the kids, even getting them into schools was a problem. But one guy who lived just down the road said, "No way, if they can't pass this road, I will take them by my vehicle." So he quickly repaired his ramshackle bus, which had started growing grass. You guys remember that? Yes. There was a bus that had been parked there, and it was there for the longest time. Grass was growing inside. But he fixed it for us. And he used to take the children to Bamburi Primary and other schools, just so that no one would harm them as they tried to walk to school. Such an angel of God. By the way, we should remember to pray for such people. So, but I want to tell you, it may look like an impossible task, but it's not. with God's help, everything is possible. That's why now I want to even just acknowledge the sponsors. Our sponsors have been so faithful. In the old earlier days, we used to have donors. They somehow disappeared. I don't know why. And I'm still trying to find others. But the word street children is no longer interesting for a lot of donors. There is other things to fund. There's COVID now. There was HIV and other things that are more interesting or look like they need more funding. To get money for street children, it's quite difficult. But Mombasa people have held our hands. Every time we do that fundraising, we make calls, and people do come through. And we have been able to sustain the children. I can tell you, there is no child that will qualify for secondary school or university who could not go because of fees. I have never had a Wema child chased away from school because of fees. Not because we have a big fat bank account. In fact, most people get shocked when they read our accounts and they're like, is this your budget? Are you missing some zeros? I'm like, no, it works. People pay for our children and then things happen. I can tell you, for example, just to mention one, African cotton. Can you see that African cotton? By the way, I put that one there just to honor people who have worked with us for many years. African cotton industries, they make sanitary pads. And they started giving us sanitary pads in the 90s, 1994. Until today, every single month they bring sanitary pads for our girls. And we don't beg them. We don't even write letters to ask. One time, I had a friend there, she is late now. Her name was Sugu Ajawala. I used to write letters. One day she called me and said, Lucy, I don't need your letters. Those are our girls. And that was it. Her family still brings parts every single month. And we just bless them and we thank God and I pray for their success. And indeed, they are successful. They are very successful. And we will continue to believe that they will continue to be successful. Not everything. Now, I just want to talk about the book a little bit in terms of why did I write this book? Everyone has a story to tell. People have always asked me, what made you, why did you do this? And I sometimes don't know how to tell in a few minutes or in a few words. So I decided to put a book together. Nothing more. We are not looking for anything. Even though we have been misunderstood sometimes. Some people think I'm looking for publicity or I want to do what, and I say, okay. Doesn't matter. It doesn't matter because God is doing his work amongst our children. You've seen them and they are just representatives of a few. So please buy the book. Buy one, buy two, buy three, buy four, buy many as you can. And we can always print more, by the way. Where is James? My publisher, tell him to print some more books. We have got demand here. So apart from that, I thought it's a good thing to launch the book like this so that we get to explain who we are to you and to also connect with those we have not connected with for some time. I actually see some new faces or people have not seen for a very long time. I want to say thank you for your support and thank you for being here today. Please buy the book. Buy as many as you can. God bless you all.
We can have some music up in here because we are about to unveil the book.